I'm not going to touch that. So the question is it okay to use third wave water? That's, I would say, its own topic, which is a water topic. Of course it's okay, right? It's fine. The big issue we've had with third wave water has been that the recipe had calcium in it. And calcium, when you make steam, is going to deposit inside, and then you need to use citric acid to remove it. So that was our big negative about third wave water. However, since I said that, third wave water themselves have bought a Decent, are very active on our forum, have, I don't know if they've tweaked their formula or what they've done, but I think it was a week or two ago, they published an extensive paper showing that all the minerals that do precipitate in their Decent come out on the next steam. So they don't feel like they have a precipitation problem. So I'd say, first of all, I don't think that there's any negative, at least not with that latest water. And then the question is, do you like the way it tastes? Is that fair?
Yeah, that's definitely fair. I mean...
We should explain what third wave water is that instead of buying like Evian or like a reverse osmosis, the cheapest way to make good water for coffee is to buy purified water. It's really cheap. It's the kind of water you'd use to put in an iron, right? It's completely removed of any minerals. It's purified water. And then you get a little sachet of some minerals that make the water appropriate for coffee. That's a really cheap way to kind of up your game. And it's a lot more eco-friendly, especially if your supermarket sells like refill of purified waters.
Yeah, and you know, it just has that convenience factor too. You know, if you don't want to dive into the water chemistry too much, or you know, you're already happy with the results, you know, I would stick with it and you know, try maybe other brands every now and again just to see that, you know, is the flavor that is the third wave water producing the flavor that I'm looking for. And
would you say it's more important the lighter you go, or is it important, period?
I think where a lot of people differentiate is how acidic they like their coffee. So if you tend to prefer quite high acidity, you may prefer a lower TDS water, especially in terms of the bicarbonates and the calcium content.
So is third wave water going to be lower TDS than what you have?
Yes, because I think the calcium content is quite high. So actually it almost produces like a neutralizing buffer for the acid. So you get drinks that are a lot more balanced in terms of acidity. But if you are a person that looks for that acidity, you will find it very difficult to achieve that level of acidity that you're looking for.
Okay. Can you cheat and put twice as much third wave powder, or half as much?
Yes, you could cheat and do half as much. But you just have to ensure that you are weighing out your what you're mixing in, so you're consistently creating the same water after batch to batch. So that would be where I would have a look into, you know, when I'm creating my water, am I affecting the way my coffee is tasting due to what I'm putting in my water again? So you don't want to create an extra problem with another problem, right?